Hello everybody, I am Nico D. Today I'm going to talk about different displays for Raspberry Pis and other SBCs. I've got a few different ones. I've got two different 3.5 inch displays. I've got two 7 inch displays. I've got my 13 inch display and of course my normal HDMI displays for my PC. So first I'm going to start with this one. This is a 3.5 inch display. It gets its power via the GPIO pins, but also the data comes from the GPIO pins. So this means this has got a low resolution. The resolution is 480 by 320. The frame rate is very low. It's about 5 frames per second. And there is also lag on it. If you move your mouse, it will take about a second to see it on the display. So this display has got its disadvantages, but the biggest advantage is it's very power efficient. I use this with my Raspberry Pi 2B. The Raspberry Pi 2B is very power efficient and this display is very power efficient. So this is a great combination. I use this mostly when I go on vacation to check if the internet connection is good on a camping spot. I use this to check my emails, to check my Facebook. When I don't have got a lot of energy in my batteries stored, then I use this one to play some games or so, just because this uses the least energy of all. So then on to the second display. This one is also a 3.5 inch display. It looks a lot like that display. It also gets its power via the GPIO pins, but only the power. It gets its data via the HDMI. So it's got an HDMI connector over here, which you can connect like this. This doesn't work on all SBCs, of course. It must have the Raspberry Pi form factor. But you can also use it without using the GPIO pins. So there is a micro USB port over here to power it. And also you have got a 3.5 millimeter audio jack over here. So this is also great for a SBC that doesn't have audio on board. You can use the audio via the HDMI with this. So this is a great display. This works at 1080p, but it is upscaled, of course. So everything you see on a normal 1080p display, you see on this. But this means that the text on here is almost unreadable. So you have to enlarge the font size to be able to read anything on here. This is great to watch movies, to play games on it. It's very good to make a handheld from it. So I love this display. It has got a crack. This happens with a lot of displays on mobile phones, of course. But this display only costs $13. So I rather have a crack in this one than on a mobile phone. Then there are the 7-inch displays. I've got two of those, but this one is broken. There is not much difference between those two, except here there was only one micro USB port, and this one has got two micro USB ports. So from this one, the micro USB port was broken off. I one time was able to solder it back onto it, but the second time I wasn't able to solder it back on anymore. I could still use it if I would solder a cable onto it, but I rather use this one. So this one has got two micro USB ports. So if one breaks, I still have got the other one to use. So this is better. This one only costs $30. This one has cost me $70. So this one is actually better than this one. The resolutions are the same. So the resolution is 1024 by 600. So it is smaller than a 1080p display, of course, what you see. So it happens that you can't see everything on your screen, but there are tricks to be able to watch those things. As last, my 13-inch display over here. I love that display. It also works with 5 volts. There are loudspeakers on the back of this display. So that's a really great display. It works at 1080p. So I will show you how to work with all these displays and how to configure them. So here we go. Here you see the Raspberry Pi 2B with the 3.5 inch touchscreen. I've got a plexiglass in front of my touchscreen to protect it, so I cannot use the touch functionality. As you see, it only uses 0.26 amps, so this is a little more than 1 watt for the Raspberry Pi 2B and the display together. So this is what I call very power efficient. As you see, it is very laggy to work with, but it does look a lot better than you see over here. My camera doesn't do it justice. To download the driver, you go here, click clone or download, and then download zip. This driver works for the WaveShare displays, but also for the clones. This is also for the 2.8-inch displays and for the 3.2-inch displays too. You can also download a Raspbian image from the WaveShare website with the driver already installed. Here I am in a clean installation of Raspbian, so I've copied the driver folder to the Pi folder. So you open the terminal, you open the folder, then you type sudo /bin/bash /lcd35-show. If you have a C model or a B model from this display, then you change that to lcd35b-show or c-show. To disable display again, you do the same, but then lcd-hdmi. Here's my 3.5-inch HDMI display with the Raspberry Pi 3B Plus. So I'm playing Tony Hawk Pro Skater. The image quality of this display is very, very good, but again, the camera doesn't show it. I've bought a new camera, but it isn't good enough for filming displays. So for this display, you don't have to change any settings. It just works as it is. It works as a 1080p display. As you see, this display is a lot better for playing games and watching movies. So this is my favorite 3.5-inch display. I've ordered a new one from AliExpress with a case for it. Altogether it was $20. I'm also gonna make it indestructible as my Raspberry Pi 2B. As you can see, you can also use this display with other SBCs that are not in the Pi form factor. So this with an HDMI cable and a USB cable for power. To make text readable in an operating system with this display, you have to enlarge the font size. Here in Ubuntu, I right click and then change desktop backgrounds, then fonts. Over there I've put everything to a font size of 22. This display uses 0.20 amps, so it is almost as much as the Raspberry Pi 2B with its display together. Then the 7-inch display, so the resolution is 1024x600 and the frame rate is 60 frames a second, so this display is also very good to play games or to watch movies. The biggest disadvantage of this display is that you can't use the HDMI sound. This display works on all my SBCs, so that is great. Only for the Raspberry Pi and the Odroids I have to change the configs, but with all the other SBCs it works just out of the box. Because of the lower display resolution, you will sometimes see a window that doesn't fit on the screen. Then you can click on that window while pressing Alt, and then you can move that window up and down so you can reach everything. To set the settings for this display on the Raspberry Pi, open the boot partition, and there open config.txt and add all this. This is also a touch screen. I've removed my plexiglass to show it, so as you see it works, but my fingers are way too big to work with it. This should work better with the stylus, but I never use touch screen. This display uses a half amp, so 2.5 watts, that only for the display. This is 2 times what the Raspberry Pi 2B uses with its 3.5 inch display. As last, my 13.3 inch display. This is just a normal 1080p display, but the special thing is that you can power it with 5 volts. So I can power it with my power banks, so this is a great display for taking with me on vacation. I truly love this display. My last trip I took it with me, it works very well. So this display also has got stereo speakers on the back. It also has got a 3.5 mm audio jack. It has got 2 HDMI in ports. You can also power it with a 19 volt adapter. This display uses 1.4 amps at 5 volts, so it is very power hungry. That is more than 6 watts only for the display. Then you also have got to power your SBC, of course. So that's it for today. I will put links in the description about all these displays. I hope you all will like my video. Thank you all for watching. See you later. Bye.